गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर इंग्लिश ग्रामर क्लास। आई होप यू ऑल आर हेल्दी एंड फिट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक, नाउंस द नेमिंग वर्ड्स। एवरीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड हैज अ नेम। ऑल नेम्स और नेमिंग वर्ड्स आर नाउंस। नेमिंग वर्ड्स are the names of a person, place, thing or an animal. Look at the following picture. Nikki and her dog are playing with football in the garden. In this picture, Nikki is the name of a person, dog is an animal, football is a thing and garden is the name of a place. Now we will study about the types of the nouns. There are two types of nouns, common nouns and proper nouns. Common nouns, a general word for a person, place, thing, animal or an idea. Proper nouns, a proper noun names a certain person, place or thing. It begins with a capital letter. For example, everyone wanted to go Pizza Hut. Mr. Smith didn't give us homework. Our game will be next Sunday. Here, Pizza Hut, Mr. Smith and Sunday are the proper nouns. Look at the following table of common and proper noun. In common nouns, name, general people, animals, places or things. In proper nouns, name, specific people, animals, places or things. Common nouns do not need capital letters, but proper nouns require capital letter. Example, singer. Or here proper noun, Taylor Swift. Let us do the practice of common and proper noun in these sentences. Here in first sentence, Ahmedabad is a big city. Ahmedabad is a proper noun and city is a common noun. I named my cat Billy. In this sentence, Billy is a proper noun and cat is a common noun. My father is a pilot in Indian Air Force. In this sentence, Indian Air Force is a proper noun and father and pilot are common noun. We are going to offer prayers at the Golden Temple. And in this sentence, Golden Temple is a proper noun. Now, we will learn about singular and plural nouns. A noun that names one person, animal, place or thing is called a singular noun. For example, a boy, a flower. A noun that names more than one person, animal, place or thing is called a plural noun. For example, flowers, cats. For most singular nouns, we add s to make their plural forms. We add es to nouns that end in ch, sh, o, s, double s, x and z to get their plural forms. The nouns that end in a consonant followed by y change into plural form by changing the y to I and then adding es. To form the plural of a noun that ends in f or fe, we replace the f or fe with ves. The nouns that end in a vowel followed by y change into plural form simply by addition of s. A few singular nouns form their plural by changing the inside vowel or vowels. Let us do the practice of some of the singular noun or plural nouns. Dog, dogs. Coat, coats. Bus, buses, brush, brushes, thief, thieves, calf, calves, cherry, cherries, army, armies, man, men, tooth, teeth. Now we will do the nouns, gender. Masculine, feminine, common and neuter are the four types of gender nouns in English. A male member of a species is a masculine gender noun. For example, uncle, king, hero, bull. A female member of a species is a feminine gender noun. For example, aunt, queen, heroine, cow. A common gender noun is used for either or both males and females. Let us do the practice of some of the masculine and feminine nouns. Bull, cow, son, daughter, horse, mare, king, queen, husband, wife, cock, hen, gentleman, lady, uncle, aunt, man, woman, bachelor, spinster, nephew, niece, monk, nun, brother, sister, wizard, witch, sir, madam, dad, mom, father, mother, daddy, mummy, lord, lady, male, female, fox, vixen, gander, goose. Let's do the next topic, possessive nouns. Nouns that show ownership or possessions are called possessive nouns. The example of possessive nouns: the boy's kite, the girl's balloons. The possessive noun shows who or what has something. Add a apostrophe s to a noun to make it possessive. You have noticed comma. We call it apostrophe. It is used to show possession.